One of the most powerful ways that you can grow on YouTube is by simply doing tutorials. And oftentimes you could do tutorials demonstrating how to use a product, or you can do tutorials by demonstrating something on screen. And we do this a lot here at Think Media, whether that's showing you how to set up a YouTube channel or create an intro for your YouTube videos or show you how to use a specific software. And so that's why in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can do screen recorded tutorials so that you can crush videos for your channel or your business. Let's go.
You gotta just press record.
Hey, what's up? It's Omar Altakori with Think Media, helping you build your influence with online video. And on this channel, sometimes we do YouTube strategy tips to help you grow your YouTube channel. Other times we talk about the best tools and even editing tutorials just like this one. So make sure to subscribe if you're interested in that. So let's jump right into step number one, and that is to download a screen capturing software. There are so many to choose from, but for this video, I'll be using Camtasia, and Camtasia is also the sponsor of this video. However, Camtasia is the best software to do screen recorded tutorials, and it's because it really is designed to do that. If you don't have Camtasia, typically you're gonna have to record your screen, then record on a camera, then record your audio separately, and then have to mix it all in post. And with Camtasia, you could simply select all your inputs, whether it's your camera, your screen, and your mic, and then when you're done doing your screen recording, it'll actually put it all together on a timeline, which makes it super easy. However, all the principles and tips in this video will be applicable no matter what software you do use. However, I'll be using Camtasia, and if you do want to check out Camtasia, be sure to check out the links down in the description below. Step number two is to plan and record your tutorial. It's so important that you take the time to prepare and plan your demonstration that you're going to be doing on screen. Because people are following along, it's best that you don't make mistakes when you do something like this, unless you're trying to show a mistake. And so I really want to encourage you to prepare and plan, because that'll actually make editing so much easier, because there'll be less things that you'll have to take out or add in. A few tips that'll help with preparation and planning is writing down your steps. If you have it written down step by step, you're gonna have something to follow along while you're demonstrating your tutorial. Secondly, is to do a dry practice run. Before you actually hit record on all the things, why don't you go through it and make sure that your, you know, pages are logged into, you're setting up programs in advance so you don't have to do something mid-record, and so that you can really set yourself up for success and also streamline the recording process of your tutorial. Also, I would encourage you in the planning and preparation phase to clean your desktop. I actually like to throw all my things on my desktop into one folder before I do a screen record. I just name it desk, drag it all in there, and then my desktop is super fresh. And then I like to turn off all my post notifications or even my text messages on my laptop. You don't want to be conducting your tutorial and potentially distract your viewers because of something happening on screen or causing you to have to start over at a certain point or what have you. So all that to say, cut the clutter, and then you'll be ready to start your tutorial. I want to encourage you to capture your entire screen. I found this super helpful because you can always zoom in later in post, and on Camtasia, it actually allows you to actually move around later in post and choose where you wanna focus on. More than anything, if you capture your whole screen, you can crop out or zoom in later when you're editing your tutorial. One thing to keep in mind is if you do make a mistake, best bet is to just pause for a second, go back a few steps, and then start again. This will just make it a lot more smoother when you do have to cut it out in post. Rather than trying to roll straight through a mistake, it might mess up the editing portion, making it hard to follow when people are watching your video. Now, prior to recording, you're essentially gonna have three sources, two at the minimum. And I would say the first two minimum sources you're gonna have is your screen to capture, and then your audio to capture. And then the third thing is to actually capture a camera. It's so much more inviting if you actually record your screen tutorials with a camera, because having your face on screen just shows, you know, another connection point when you're trying to demonstrate something. It just makes it a lot more enjoyable to watch. And you know, when we do it here on Think Media, we usually put ourselves in like a circle or a square, but keeping your face on top of the screen recording is super nice. But you're gonna wanna set those three things up: your screen, your audio, and your camera. And again, I know I mentioned it earlier, Camtasia makes this so easy because you can literally select all your inputs at once and then conduct your tutorial, and then later on you can make those fine-tune adjustments in the way you want to make it look, which I'll talk about in just a moment. But if you didn't have Camtasia, you just want to make sure that your screen potentially has audio so that you can sync it in post, as well as your camera and the mic you're using. Maybe you have your mic connected to your camera, or you have your mic connected to your computer. Either way, make sure all sources have audio so that you can sync it in post. Now, if you're not using Camtasia, and with all the sources that you may need, make sure you clap right when you start so that you could sync your audio right before you start editing it. And it also gives a good visual when it comes to syncing audio as well. The first thing I would recommend is a good mic. And the mic I would recommend is the Samson Q2U. This is about a $70 USB mic that you can literally plug into your computer or laptop, and it sounds phenomenal. Gives you that nice radio rich podcast kind of sound, but it also eliminates a lot of sounds outside of your computer. You know, maybe you have a fan coming on or something like that, but I would say it's the best, most affordable USB mic that we recommend for creators. The second thing I would encourage you to do is to potentially get a capture card. This cheap capture card that we recommend is about $25 or so at the time of shooting this video, and you can literally use this capture card with any camera that has an HDMI out. The next thing I would encourage you to invest in is by using a camera, and you can totally use your smartphone. And if you wanna learn how to use your smartphone as a webcam, be sure to check out the links down in the description below and I'll link that video. But if you have a camera laying around, chances are is that you can actually use that camera as a webcam, or maybe even just use it to record simultaneously while you're doing your screen recording. But you wanna use a USB capture card. This is gonna turn your camera into a webcam. And honestly, for around $25 with maybe an $8 purchase for the cord itself needed to plug from the camera into the capture card, you're looking at about $30 to be able to turn your camera into a webcam, which will level up your production quality when you're making these tutorials. And then when you're ready to put that all together, simply conduct your live stream tutorial, and then we'll get into step number three, which is editing your video. With Camtasia, it puts your recording all on a timeline, which is super nice and easy. And then all you gotta do is make adjustments rather than having to set everything up, which is super cool. Now, the first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna put your face down into a corner. I like using either the bottom right or the bottom left corner, depending on what needs to be seen on screen. As you can see, I'm at the bottom right of the screen, and good rule of thumb is that you don't need the full, you know, picture or resolution of your main shot down on the bottom of the screen. You can actually put yourself in a square or in a circle using what is called a mask effect. And I'm just gonna drag this mask effect onto myself. And now I can select a shape that I want my face to be in. And I'm gonna select a circle because circles are cool. And another good rule of thumb is to make your face take majority of the space. Don't put too much chest space or too much head space. Make yourself very visible, because more than anything, people are looking at your eyes and your emotion. And so make sure you make your face a little bit bigger in that space. And that may require you to zoom in a little bit to be able to dial in those settings. Once you've dialed both those things in, then you can just go through your screen recorded tutorial and cut out any mistakes or pauses that you may have throughout it. Now, one thing you can do is jump to and from your face, you know, on top of the screen, and then jumping to the main angle without the screen capture. Having more movement throughout your tutorial, especially if it's a YouTube video, might help with viewer duration, which is pretty smart and wise to do. And so you can do that throughout your tutorial where needed. Maybe you're talking about something and it's not really demonstrating something, so just cut to your face, talk about it, and then when you're showing something, cut back to the screen. Another thing in regards to movement and cutting, you can actually zoom in and out throughout your tutorial if you want to emphasize something. With Camtasia, they have great features to be able to zoom in smoothly and then zoom out smoothly. Camtasia also has cursor effects, so if you want to put a spotlight around the mouse and maybe dim out something on the screen and only focus on where the mouse is, or you want to put a highlighter color around the mouse or whatever color you'd like, you can do so. Another additional movements you could simply add is text, and by adding either title screens or just text on screen could definitely help your tutorial. I love how Camtasia has stock motion backgrounds and moving text, and really you can create title screens inside of Camtasia with these features. Just simply put a stock motion background and then whatever text or step or tip you're communicating, put that in text, and then now you easily created a title screen for your video. Now, once you're done editing your screen recorded tutorial, it's time to export it and upload it to YouTube. And bonus tip, yes, I got a bonus tip for you, and that is to repeat this process and be consistent. One of the best ways to grow on YouTube is to simply be consistent. Show up for the people that have subscribed to your channel, and show up to the people that have yet to subscribe to you by creating tutorials to be discovered in search. And I hope you got value in this video, and if you did, hit that like button, and shout out to Camtasia for sponsoring this video. Camtasia really is, I would say, the best screen recorded software. that you can use, and it really just streamlines the process. If you want to check out a discount link that you could save 10% with, make sure to check out the link down in the description below. And if you want to check out another video from Think Media, click or tap the screen, and I can't wait to see you in a future video. Peace.